Welcome to this edition of Cardinal Corner. I'm honored to have our head of school, Lauren Smith, join us. And, well, it's interesting because we've all heard the stories. He was born here, raised here, went here, and now he's back. So let's kind of start with the beginning. What was it like growing up here on campus?
Well, obviously, I didn't know any other place or way to grow up, but it was amazing. We had, probably 15 or so young faculty, children at the time, faculty brats. At one point, we had the faculty brat bike squad with our own flags for the backs of our bikes. We published the faculty brat gazette on purple mimeograph newspaper, the only thing I remember from that was we announced babysitting rates were going up from, I think, 20 to 25 cents an hour or something like that. So it was wonderful. We had forts out in the woods, and every day I'd come home from school and drop my books and get outside and play. And it was just really couldn't be a better place to have 150 big brothers. We probably drove them nuts, but it was an amazing place to grow up.
And what similarity? It's funny because you described that, and it's very similar to still what it is today.
Yeah.
So that's, it's a blessing for us to be able to raise our kids here to see that. They're not making a publication yet. I think that would be interesting to see. They're definitely riding bikes. Definitely kind of have that mentality and that purpose. Just this group, and they know they've got the 150 brothers. The saddest part for them, I think, is every year when we have to explain to them that this group of guys graduates. But don't worry, because there's a new group coming in September.
And these guys will be back to see.
Yeah. Have you maintained any ties to any of those, the boys that came ahead that looked at you as kind of a younger brother?
Yeah, I think that's probably the one of the most enjoyable parts of my job now is to get back in touch with them. And people who I haven't seen in 50 or more years, to check in and see what they're doing. Some gentlemen who were babysitters when I was 3 or 4 years old, and now I'm back in contact with them. It's an awful lot of fun.
What's their reaction to now you being the head of school? So somebody that they babysat when they went to the school, they actually have their love for self-care. And now they're sitting there going, wait, this guy is not the head of school?
I really don't know. I don't know how to answer that question. I think my father would be laughing himself silly if he were still with us, the fact that I was hired as head of school. But I don't know how the alums, we'll have to ask them.
I think that's what we have to do. One of the things that my goals with this Cardinal Corner is to, branch out of us and start getting the alums on here and start talking to them about what they see and how they feel. Now you got, move forward. Obviously, you grew up here, you went here. You made great bonds and friendships because obviously we get to see that with your connection with those on the Board of Trustees and others on Alumni Weekend when we get to celebrate Alumni Weekend. What was it like coming back and becoming head of school?
Well, I think, because I worked here for 9 years fairly soon after I graduated from college. And I think at that point, in the back of my mind, I was thinking, I'd love to be a head of school somewhere. I thought about South Kent, and I said, it'd be great to be back here. But then I left and I started teaching at some other places. And the more I taught, the more I realized that's really who I am. I'm not an administrator at heart. I don't consider myself administrator. Certainly, I don't really consider myself head of school. So when the opportunity came to come back here, by that time in my life, I really put that thought way out of my mind. It wasn't even something that I was interested in entertaining, except for the opportunity to do it here. So coming back here has been very special, because I still feel I'm not really an administrator. I'm still a teacher at heart. And because of our size and our flexibility and the creativity of our faculty and staff, I can still do, nowhere near to the extent that I had before, but I can still do things as far as I think being creative in our academic program and our other programming to really make sure that no one is doing things better than we are. I get a little uncomfortable when people say, you know, we are the best, because there are a lot of great schools and a lot of great ways of doing things. But to get back to your question, so coming back here has been the best of sort of all of my different worlds leading up to this point. Not many people get to finish up their career where they started out, especially in a place that I love so much. But I can still do many of the things that I'm doing at other schools, still be able to I enjoy figuring out better ways of doing things, new ways of doing things, and we can do that here. So I'm not really answering your question. I don't know what it's like to come back as head of school, because I don't think of myself.
Well, maybe that was
the boss.
Who was your head of school when you were at South Carolina?
George Bartlett.
So, and everybody knows, you know, George is, it's just George. It's like everybody knows the man.
Yep.
But, so in your mind, was that what you thought a head of school, or were you more in tune to how everything has changed?
Both. Because I've been in the independent school world for my entire career, I'm very aware that the job itself has evolved a great deal. I think it's a very, very different job than what Mr. Bartlett did. And I'm very aware of that just because I've been in the independent school world for a long time, and I've seen this from afar. I do think being head of school here is probably the closest you can get to being a more traditional or old-fashioned head of school. Most of my friends who have this position in other schools really not involved in any of the day-to-day operations of the school, and they can't be. And they are running a business that happens to take place in the school. And yes, they got into it because they're educators at heart, but it's just, it's a very different world, and the job is 180 degrees different than it was when I was a student here, when George was the head of school.
I think you made an interesting comment. You're not an administrator, you're an educator at heart. That part. Knowing so many heads of school that we've had, I think that's what's made this place special, is that none of them are really just straight administrators.
Right.
I think the closest one in my memory would be kind of a John Farber, who had, you know, very set specific skills, but he could do, you know, a little bit of both. But South Kent has always thrived on having that person who's that overall community leader, you know, to help bring everybody together.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's interesting.
And that's the only thing that really attracted me to the job. I think if I would not be interested in doing this if it was a position that most of my colleagues doing this job have to fill. If it was sort of a modern head of school's position, I would not be that interested. But I'm very interested, obviously, in doing it all here, because it's as you've said, it's a very different job.
Yeah, it's something the boys always remember. Fondly, I always remember my head of school, and I think the boys always, no matter what, with their time here, they're going to remember that, you know, that person who was, who got to call the days off. I think that's all they remember. who got to call the days off? That's the most important thing. And as long as it was because there was a baby, you know, that's a right. It has to happen. If you don't do that, well, you're in trouble.
Yeah. Well, I it's funny you mention that, because our tradition, yes, of having holidays for male babies. I have a twin sister, and for as long as we've been alive, I remind her that the holiday was for me and not for her. And there are still some, I still run into people on occasion who were here at school at the time, who were upset that the same Bartlett didn't give them 2 days off because
two babies.
Yeah, we only got one, or they only got one, and I'm pretty sure it was because of me.
Well, the boys do that all the time, trust me. They hold that stuff, they remember. They right away, they know somebody's pregnant, they're sitting there going, okay, is it fall? When is it coming?
Yeah.
What would you say has been the biggest challenge? Hey, you've been throwing a lot of new challenges in 3 years.
I think the biggest challenge is COVID. I think we were doing a lot of things really well. Not that we're not doing things well with COVID, but it's just, you know, every day is a different opportunity that presents us, and it changes. It changes constantly, and so it's handling COVID with everything from the curricular end of things to the health side of things to the financial side of things to the relationships with the community. I mean, these are challenges that no one anticipated. Certainly, I didn't anticipate. It's made the job very different than the one that I thought I was going to do, which is fine. But that's by far been the biggest challenge. I think the other things, realigning our curriculum, re-engaging our alumni body, being a little more deliberate in some of our strategic planning. I think we've done a really good job of that. There have been some challenges there, certainly, but they were all anticipated. You can see them coming. And that's the biggest problem with COVID, is the unpredictability of it and the fear of the unknown, I think, which is a little unnerving.
You know, not to just put us in a set of time, but we're here in week 11, which is pretty impressive, you know, of having in-person education.
Yep.
You know, it's not that we're patting ourselves on the back. It's been a lot of hard work, a lot of people who put in a lot of planning, timing, you name it, to make sure this gets pulled off, including our students, our families, everybody.
Yeah.
Because it hasn't been easy on anybody. You see, you know, our emails that we get, our phone calls, the posts on social media, how difficult it is for the parents to not see their kids.
Yeah.
This is such a different separation. And yet we then also have kids who have been here almost an entire year on this campus.
No.
And they're still, now we're looking at it and going, they're still probably going to be here for a couple more months without being able to go home. So it's been a difficult challenge for all of them.
It has indeed. Yeah. It's been really difficult, and I'm impressed every single day by the commitment of all members of the community, from the students to the staff to the faculty to our alumni supporting us. You know, it's been remarkable. I'm regularly reminded of something George Bartlett told me that is, we've always struggled in good times, and we've always done pretty well in tough times, and that's certainly coming true here. Not the struggling in the good times, but we're doing pretty well. I think we're doing certainly as well as can be expected, you know, in pretty trying circumstances.
And we count on that. Our alums, our friends, our families, who not only supported us, but also supported us financially. It's been a very difficult time for everybody, but they've also, like always, they step up when it's needed.
Yep.
You know, looking forward, you look at 2021 thinking, okay, maybe, hopefully, we can have that prize day for that class of 2020. We can have that alumni weekend again where we get the community together, but we don't know. So it's just kind of moving forward.
Yeah. I was thinking a couple days ago, we could be in a position where we'll have to celebrate 3 prize days at once or something. But we'll do it. Then we just, when we can, we'll do it.
Now, where do you see South Kent? Because one of the fun things that we see down the road is obviously our centennial.
Yeah.
And that's pretty exciting. Not everybody survives 100 years, you know, gets to 100 years. And hopefully we're all there to cross that line together. What's the exciting thing? What do you see next for South Kent as we get to that centennial?
Gosh. Well, if you look at the 3 legs of our stool, so academic, community life, and athletic, because that's how I tend to view everything you do. And then on top of that, I think the a lot of threes here. But looking at people, program, place is sort of prioritized how we look at the 3 different areas. And then you can look at our mission and our values, which we're doing everything possible to apply them in the 21st century and moving ahead. So some combination of all those things. So let's go back to academics. We're working to create one curriculum, and it will not just be an academic curriculum, but a curriculum that will spread across form levels as well as in departments, So sort of vertically and horizontally, to make sure that the boys are getting consistent messaging, consistent lessons in everything that they do that are coordinated between the classroom and in the dorms and from the chapel, on the rink or the basketball court or the soccer pitch or riding the trails in the woods or doing music, you know, whatever it is. We want to make sure that we are passing on to them the values that we've always passed on to them, but in ways that are present and necessary for the 21st century. And it's a balancing act between the past and all the things, all the wonderful things that we've done that have made the school what it is, and applying those to a world, as our mission statement says, you know, in a rapidly changing world. So how do you marry the whole and been critical back then, which is going to be, I'm absolutely convinced, even more critical moving ahead. So, bigger than academics, but working with the academics, just one curriculum. We've already started that by reducing our academic departments just down to two academic departments, and they're beginning to work together even more closely. So, we're on our way there. I think that's important. The community life, we're starting to be more deliberate and specific in developing a community life curriculum, which will be work in concert with the academic curriculum. We're looking forward to being able to do jobs again. That's one of the saddest things, I think, as far as COVID, is that we had to put our jobs program on pause. But to make sure that we continue to teach the boys what it means to be an active and engaged member of our community in all different areas. And then tie that into the athletics, where we obviously had a great deal of success, looking for a great deal more. But I want to be able to be sure that when a boy gets his diploma on prize day, we know that they're well-grounded in these different areas. We know they've been exposed to and had to consider all of these different things. And it's not just an academic program where they play really good sports and go to chapel, but in fact, it's a united curriculum across the world. So that, I think, is my biggest goal. And then in order to do that, we've got to make sure that we continue to attract the highest quality student as well as the highest quality faculty member. And I don't mean the number of degrees, but just the people who thrive here and help us thrive as a community are ones who are so thoughtful and loving and careful with our boys, as they always have been. We continue to find those people to support them when they're here, to make them want to stay for their entire careers. So we have to take care of our people, and the program we're going to talk about a little bit, and then finally we have to take care of the place. And you know, we don't need much. We can thrive pretty simply, as we always have, but I think we should make sure that we really take care of what we have, make sure that as our facilities go and our campus goes, we have what we need. We don't have anything extra, we don't have frills, but we really take care of what we have and appreciate it.
Well, that's excellent. I tell you, I'm looking forward to that. 2023, 2024 coming around. It'll be pretty fast. It comes fast. Although
scary.
It is scary. But is there anything else you want to leave, kind of end on, let our great people know?
No.
It's a great time, I tell you that.
Just if anybody has thoughts, suggestions, ideas, comments, please get in touch and let me know. I enjoy contact with all people, all supporters of South Kent, and we're able to take criticism, I think, fairly well. If you have an idea or would like to have a conversation that's going to make us better, please get in touch and let me know. Love to do it.
Thanks for joining us on this edition of the Cardinal Corner.
My privilege, Johnson. Thank you.